expired, and we now recognize Mr. Gohmert for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Madam Chairman. And I got to say, this really warms my heart to hear witnesses from both sides having so much good input. It was my observation during the Bush years that the Department of Justice was able to convince Republicans, many of them, a majority of them, no, we don't need any reform right now, and really pushed back and convinced Republicans that were in charge to back off of some reforms we should have made. And I noticed resistance like that. I'm sure a lot of pressure from the Obama administration on Democrats that were in charge not to do some reform that was needed. So when I hear the testimony and the questions and hear this in such a great bipartisan way, something that is so serious, it really does warm my heart. Some great comments and great questions. Dr. Alexander, I note you're careful to make sure that you note that this technology can be helpful. And then it sends me thinking back about our FBI. You think the technology on recording statements instead of the FBI having their agents not record statements, audio or video, but just write down their version of what the witness, do you think the technology has gone too fast for the FBI that maybe we could get them to start recording with audio, at least maybe video? And I am being sarcastic, but that is an area of concern for me. If you combine facial recognition mistakes with the FBI's ability to only record, only write down what their version of what the witness says, you combine flaws like that, then we are looking at some serious problems at the federal level. Local, I'm sure your law enforcement that over which you oversaw recorded statements, so that wouldn't be such a problem. But can you see regulations, Dr. Alexander, that would help us be able to confine facial recognition just to the investigative stage? So that, and as a former judge, you know, I know sometimes law enforcement will come in and they'll go, now, Judge, this is, you know, in the affidavit, but, you know, hey, we did also. Well, if you didn't swear to it, I don't want to hear it. But that discrimination of a real sworn evidence to unsworn evidence isn't always distinguished by some judges. You see some regulations we could utilize to actually get some teeth into that?
Well, and thank you for that question, Congressman Gohmert. I think, first of all, let me say, I think the FBI has the tendency, has the ability, has the training, and also has the fidelity of a federal law enforcement agency that is well trusted. And everything that they have pursued, particularly around technology, they really kind of stood up on technology, if you go back 100 years with them, in terms of the work that they did back then and they do today, forensically. But they do have great capability of being able to access that type of technology and use it in a way that is standardized, one in which they have best practices, one in which they are really are the leaders around the utilization, because they use this technology to go after our foreign actors who want to do harm to this country, or to utilize this even in domestic cases.
Dr. Alexander, my time is short, but
yeah, but
I am very concerned that about some of their abuses. And when we see the FISA court that meets in secret, and then there doesn't seem to be any checks. And like I say, as a former judge, I'm very offended that some judges have not been outraged, like Mr. Williams' treatment and others. I think that is a problem when the judiciary is not upset enough to actually take action and bring law enforcement into line. But let me ask Mr. Tolman, do you see a way to get specific regulations that would discern between investigation and actually going to court and getting a warrant and picking up somebody like Mr. Williams?
Yeah, I think you could implement things such as not allowing for the facial recognition technology to launch an investigation, that they would have to have independent basis to launch the investigation. And then ultimately, if it went to trial, you could utilize facial recognition technology as additional evidence, but it you can't have it the other way around, because then you have concerns about whether the evidence that is corroborating the facial recognition technology is simply influenced by the subjectivity of the investigators.
Well, thank you. My time's expired. Thank you very much, Chairwoman Lee. I really appreciate this hearing.
Thank you so very much, Mr. Gohmert. We're more and more finding some common ground.